No, I figure I'd talk to him tomorrow at the hospital.
The police got a call on the tip line. A man matching his description was aggravating a teenage girl.
Hey, you can't take those.
My daddy told you 2 days ago to stay away from me. I told him about you creeping up again yesterday.
You see me coming near you? Mm-mm. I'm way over here, and I'm gonna stay over here. But you stop harvesting.
Why should I? This is my daddy's weed and my daddy's shed. You're trespassing.
I don't care whose shed it is. That's not your weed.
Not yours either.
It belongs to the folks I work for.
Oh, really? They didn't grow it?
Grown on their land.
Grown on state land.
Oh, you gonna be a lawyer now?
Is this how come you've been perving on me?
Now, how have I been perving on you? Have I exposed myself? Have I made any lewd or unwanted comments toward you? No, I have not.
Well, right now, you're talking to a 14-year-old girl you have no reason to be talking to.
I have a reason to be talking to you. You're trying to steal something don't belong to you.
I told you to stay back.
Yes, ma'am. Okay. Fine. Where's your mama? Did she die? Or did she run off? You miss your mama? At your age, I imagine you do. I mean, a girl your age. She needs somebody to talk to. It's not like your daddy could do a good job of that. It's not like you could talk to him about your period.
You wouldn't be the one to talk to me about that?
Well, I'm closer in age.
Not by much.
Well, come on, I just turned 30.
Any man over 18 talking to me about my period is a pervert. Shit, any man, period, talking to me about my period.
Period, that's funny. You are very funny. That's good stuff.
Is this gonna be your new line? Now we got the same sense of humor? What's in your mind? How do you think this is gonna go? Thinking maybe, ooh, we'll fight a little, then it'll turn into wrestling and tickling and laughing, and then she'll say, ooh, don't touch me there, and then she won't stop me? Is that how it runs in your head? You don't even know what to say now, do you? Even me talking about wrestling and tickling and ooh, don't touch me there, it's like a spell's been cast and you don't want to break it. Maybe you're just dreaming and you don't want to wake up. Well, wake up!
God damn it!
I tried nice with you. Hell, I tried friendly. It ain't worked yet. You know, people ask me why I came back here to Harlan. And I tell them it's because the Bennett boys gave me a job. But honestly, that's not it. That's not it at all. I came back here because of you, Loretta.
He works for them. When he came by here, he just said he was some bank man.
Well, he followed me to the shed.
Oh, Jesus.
What's wrong?
I called that tip line this morning.
Daddy, I told you not to do that.
But don't worry, it's anonymous.
All right, well, I'll go talk to Max. She likes me.
Freddy, when you talk to her, don't say anything about squirreling.
Well, with the perv working for her, she already knows, Daddy.
You know, with our little cons.